Hello. In this WAGO tutorial, we will show you different ways to find a controller in an IP network, how to assign an IP address, and how to communicate with it. All WAGO controllers have web-based management to configure the controller. You can access the web-based management by entering the controller's IP address in a web browser. We start with a PFC200, whose IP address we know. So we enter this into the web browser and the web-based management opens. Once logged in, we open the configuration tab and in the networking menu, we find the TCP/IP configuration section where we can configure the network settings. Our PFC has a static IP address with this subnet mask and no gateway is specified. How an IP address is constructed, what a subnet mask is, and in which case a gateway is needed, we show in another tutorial that we have linked in the video description. As is usual with networkable devices, a WAGO controller is set to DHCP by default. DHCP stands for Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. This means that the IP address is not manually assigned by us and then remains static. Instead, the controller is assigned an IP address by a DHCP server when it logs onto the network. This may change if the device is disconnected from the network, for example by rebooting, and then reconnected. The DHCP server is often provided by a router. The advantage of DHCP is that you can integrate network devices directly into a network, and you don't have to worry about IP address conflicts due to duplicate assignments and so on. The disadvantage is that our controller then has an unknown IP address, which we don't know, and we can't access it to open the web-based management as shown above. Especially in an industrial environment, static IP addresses are often used at the network level of the controller. However, even when installing an application on the controller, depending on the network structure and policies, it may be helpful to first connect the controller directly to the PC, assign a static IP address, install the application, and then, if necessary, switch the controller back to DHCP and integrate it into the target network. It is also possible to install an application using DHCP. WAGO provides a number of tools and options to enable a controller to be configured for a wide range of applications. A very popular option is to first connect the controller to a service cable and then edit the network settings using Ethernet settings. The WAGO Ethernet Settings software tool is available free of charge from the WAGO Download Center. For controllers that have been on the market for a long time, such as the PFC100, PFC200, and BC100, the WAGO Service Cable 75923 is available. The newer controllers, such as the PFC300, CC100, or Edge Controller, have a USB-C interface for this purpose. We will start with the PFC200 and the service cable, for which we have already installed the driver. In the WAGO Ethernet settings, open the communication window by clicking on the settings button. Under connection, select serial port and then the WAGO USB service cable. Confirm by clicking on apply. The controller is found and we can assign a static IP address in the network tab. The source is still set to DHCP server. We set this to static configuration and enter the desired IP address, a subnet mask and, if necessary, a gateway, which we leave blank here. The right button transfers the configuration to the controller, and when we enter the IP address in the web browser, the controller's WBM opens and we are connected. As an example of a controller with a USB-C interface, we have a CC100 connected to a PC with a USB-C cable. Now we start the controller and once it has booted up, we open the Ethernet settings. Now select the Ethernet TCP/IP connection. The IP address of the controller on the USB port is 192.168.42.42. A little background. The controllers with a USB service interface have a built-in USB Ethernet adapter, which means that the USB interface in the controller locks onto the PC as an Ethernet interface, and we can then use it as an Ethernet interface. However, this interface can only be used as a service interface. When we apply the communication settings, the controller is detected and displayed. If we now open the network tab, we can see that the controller is set to DHCP for the switched Ethernet interfaces X1 and X2, and we could now give it a static IP address. However, the USB Ethernet interface also gives us the option of assigning the IP address directly in the web-based management system rather than using the Ethernet settings. To do this, we open the web browser and enter the IP address 192.168.42.42. The web-based management opens and we enter a static IP address for X1. We then enter the newly assigned IP address in the web browser, the WBM reopens, and we are connected. But now not via the USB cable, but via the Ethernet interface of the controller. Another way to find a controller is to scan the network. This is also possible with VAGO Ethernet settings. If the controller is running on a particular network and has received any IP address in the subnet, either via DHCP or statically, we can scan an address range in the communication settings in Ethernet settings using the scan button. In this case, we are on the 192.168.1 network and are scanning all possible network addresses from 1 to 254. This will take some time, but our controller will be found and its IP address will be displayed. Another way to access the controller is to use the reset button to assign a temporary static IP address to the controller. 192.168.1.17. Set the CC100 we have just used to stop and press the small reset button RST for at least 8 seconds until the system LED flashes orange. Now we can access the controller, for example in a web browser, using the IP address 192.168.1.17 and assign it an IP address. It is important to note that the temporary fixed IP address is always 192.168.1.17 and is only active until the next reboot. Therefore, this address is not suitable for installing an application as the controller will be rebooted during the installation process and will no longer be accessible. In this case, you should first use the fixed IP address function to assign a correct static IP address, which must not be 192.168.1.17 again, and then install the application. This fixed IP address mode is also available for most VAGO controllers. Another option we would like to present here is to run a DHCP server with the VAGO Upload software tool. A VAGO Upload is required for many tasks where data needs to be sent from the PC to the controller or vice versa, be it a firmware update, the installation of an application, or the transfer of a license key. VAGO Upload is also available free of charge from the Download Center. VAGO Upload does not need to be installed. It is a directly executable .exe file. Now open any category, for example firmware update, and go directly to the target controller selection window. We want to access the controller via the Ethernet interface, so we select transfer via TCP/IP. On the right-hand side is the drop-down menu to enable DHCP. First select the Ethernet port on the PC to which the controller is connected, and tick the box for DHCP. Click on the gray box next to the arrow to activate DHCP. The text will now turn red, and after a few seconds, the controller will be displayed with its MAC address. Unlike what you are used to with your home router, for example, an IP address is not assigned automatically. Instead, you can enter an IP address manually. This means that although we are using the DHCP protocol, we are manually assigning the IP address, with all the advantages and disadvantages that this brings. The DHCP function can be disabled, and when we search for the controller using the IP address, it will be found. There is another important feature we would like to show you. If we now connect to Ethernet settings or WBM, we can see that the controller has been configured with a static IP address in the network settings. This is because VAGO Upload can find a controller configured with DHCP, but if you then assign an IP address to it, it will be assigned as a static IP address. If you want to get the controller back to DHCP, you have to reset it in the WBM or with Ethernet settings. On some WAGO controllers, it is also possible to set the IP address using DIP switches. Please refer to the controller manuals for a detailed explanation of which address ranges can be set or how to enable DHCP. There are also a number of other ways to assign an IP address, such as using the WAGO solution platform, device manager, NUpload file, and so on. But this is beyond the scope of this tutorial and is also very controller or application specific. And that's the end of our tutorial on how to connect to a controller and how to assign an IP address. Please give us a thumbs up if you found this video helpful, subscribe to the channel, and contact the WAGO Support Center if you have any questions.